8,800 pounds triple slide cruiser, originally sold right here at Haylett RV of Coldwater, Michigan, coming back to us on trade. Beautifully well kept, park kept RV. Not really any towing miles on this one. The RV has been used, but very well maintained. Really, the only sign of wear and tear I can see is on some of the seating where they just spent the majority of their time. The folks decided that they were done keeping the RV parked in one spot, but wanted something a little bit smaller and more comfortable for towing, and swapped this out for a 26-foot ultralight couples camper here at Haylett RV. I mentioned the wear and tear items. I always try to get, like, if I see something off, I guess you could say, on a used RV, I'll go out of my way to say something about it. And really right here on the seating, you can just see where scooting around on the seats has had a little bit of wear on it. The recliners in the back look pretty good. You do have to twist the recliners to close the slides, and it is kind of a tight fit in there. And as a result, a couple times it looks like that slide fascia got nicked on either side. The other thing was these window treatments. Like, you see how there's these window brackets down here? Those look like they got cracked by those recliners when they were twisted off on both sides. And that is the end of the bad news list. It's pretty minor stuff. It is a nicely kept, spacious, opposing slide living room, bedroom closet slide fifth wheel it came in. We sold this when it was brand new. I really have always felt that this was like the golden age generation of cruiser fifth wheels from the Crossroads RV family. It's not that the stuff that they're making today is bad. It's fine. It's just that it's not this. These are sharp. Now, I got tons of light pouring in through the windows, and it really kind of skews the color patterns that we're looking at. So if I get up here a little bit closer, you get a little bit more of a truer estimation of how everything actually looks, because I got glare on everything the way those windows are set up. What's nice about this floor plan is it just gives us gobs of windows. Windows all over the place that, you know, you get lots of airflow, lots of visibility, and it doesn't matter, you know, what side of the RV on or where you're sitting, there's really no bad seat in here. All the original owner's manuals and electronics and everything appear to be present and accounted for, and I'm going to give you just a quick overview of everything closed up, then we'll get our kitchen space open, because this is a floor plan very much designed around a very comfortable living space. But it has surprisingly good kitchen storage. It's just kind of split up across the middle of the RV, and it's a little bit easy to miss. And it begins, you can see when the sun died down, you get, like I said, a truer estimation of the actual color palette in here. You can see it begins with a lot of drawers. And if we count them up, there's 3, 6, 8 drawers right there. And you're almost, you know, tripping over them. There's so many drawers. That's a larger 22-inch oven also, and even from just right here, you can see 3 sets of easy reach appliance outlets, which is really, really handy. 8 cubic foot fridge freezer, and we have ourselves some pretty good cabinet capacity as well. Also, a nicely hidden away master control panel that you see in the bottom right of that upper cabinet there. Keeps away from little grandkid guest fingers. Good space here for a wastebasket too. That's something that this brand was definitely ahead of the curve on, because there's still quite a few RVs built today that don't match up to that. So, stainless sink with big fitted one-piece cover is a nice touch. And you're looking at it and go, yeah, that's nice, but where's my pantry space? Ah, that is where we run into RV nerdism number 37, the pantrytainment center. And this is a chunk of storage. Now, what's nice is the pantry vertically on the right-hand side, that's all adjustable, removable cabinetry. So, if you want to kind of, you know, change up the arrangement or how much space or storage is between them, you have full control over that, which is really, really handy. Nice double vanity up in the bathroom gives you plenty of cabinet space. It's not just the double mirrors. It's that behind each of those is a nice big deep cabinet and good counter space in here with plenty of room for things, you know, like toothbrush holders, place to put a blow dryer, etc. As we weave our way over here, the porcelain foot flush stool, well, that's easy to see, but what's easy to miss is if you notice all the way up this left side, we have ourselves extra, like, linen space. They really utilize every single nook and cranny because, you know, there's a lot of brands that do still and have built RVs in this class and category where they really, really want to preach, you know, the concept of, like, ultralight fifth wheeling, which is a little bit of a misnomer in a sense, because fifth wheels are just so much bigger, they have to be heavier, but ultralight is kind of a generic phrasing anyway. My point, though, is that's not ever what Cruiser was really trying to do with these. Their goal was to make something that is beautiful and will stay that way and will stay out of the service centers. And they were very successful at that for quite some time. 60 by 80 true queen bed, and like most things in this class, even today, there is a little step here, but it is not really that drastic. Storage below the bed, hanging storage on either side. I don't know how useful it is, but I'd rather always have something than nothing. There are power outlets up here above those top stands. I don't know if that's really CPAP friendly necessarily, but better than nothing, I do suppose. This is 50 amp service, by the way. It's a one air coach, but if you want to add a second air up here in the bedroom, you can do so. And again, both of those side stands on either side of the bed, they are hanging closets, which is nice. Handy little upper shelf too. But over here, you see, you can either make this extra closet space on the left 2/3, or extra dresser space, or a combination thereof, and there's always extra dresser space on the right. And should you need it, across from the bed, up in the corner here, you see that you do have TV hookups for the bedroom. Pass-through compartments of RVs are something I've long felt is a really good indicator. It's kind of, how did they really take care of something? And as you can see here, that looks factory fresh down inside there. Double slam latches make, for kind of easy in and out there. The stable steps that you find on a lot of things, whether it's Mooride or LCI or whatever, those have become very, very popular. If I'm eyeballing it right, that door is wide enough, it should be able to accommodate a set of those, should you be so inclined. Nose cap, showing no real signs of like fade, flake, anything like that. Maybe a little bit of exposure at the top, but it could also just be the way that the sun is hitting this thing right now. It's kind of hard to tell from my angle. Again, this, the way the sun's coming in currently is really washing out some things, color-wise. The walls in this are also a 2-inch thick, and it does have a pretty good extended season package. Both of those things, the extended season package, everybody and their brother likes to tout nowadays. Cruiser was ahead of that curve. But most brands are using a 1.5-inch sidewall, which is fine. It's just that this gives you a little more sound dampening, a little bit more insulation. It's not actually any more structure, though. That's a common misconception about things. And one of the areas cruisers were really outstanding in their class and category during this time period is that high gloss, super reflective skin package. And it's kind of funny because we've suddenly seen 3 or 4 of these come in on trade, all in really, really good condition. It was a brand that really appealed to an educated, discerning buyer. And those folks tend to be the type of people that really take care of their stuff. And as you're seeing here, that trend obviously seems to apply. The receiver hitch on the back of this is intended for accessories, not for like towing. But I do know some people had a tendency to bulk those up for, doing some recreational doubles towing. That's not exactly the hardest thing to do. And you don't have to worry about losing warranty on a used RV when you do that. And by the way, you have power front leveling jacks, power rear stabilizers, everything's push button easy. And one more area this brand was kind of ahead of the curve is up top here. Like if you look around in the distance, if you see a lot of the different trailers and fifth wheels that we carry here at Haylet RV, a white exterior and white roof has come back into fashion, as you see maybe on that Cougar way, way over there. Well, this is kind of in the same class and category as that, and they were a little bit ahead of the curve. With the white skin, the white roof, it will organically help shed a ton of heat. It just will help keep itself pretty comfortable in summer. And again, 15,000 BTU central air on this with the option of adding second air. Now these all appear to be the original factory seals, and they appear to be fine, which really, especially with the cleanliness of this roof, heavily indicates this was very well proactively maintained, washed and conditioned, which is kind of like the equivalent of putting sunscreen on your camper. It's like, if you only do one thing to your RV, using a regular wash and conditioner is about the best thing you can possibly do to it. And we have that stuff available over there in our parts and service center, and we love to share that knowledge here at Haylet RV. So whether it is new, used, or otherwise, actually there's their new little lightweight trailer and their vehicle right there getting ready to head out. There's really not much we don't do here at Haylet RV. Basically, the only thing we don't do is hidden dealer fees. So sorry for the convenience. So take care, stay safe, have fun, and happy Haylet camping, everyone.